Hi friends, welcome back to the React.js Advanced Concept Series. So far, we have learnt about different hooks in React. Hooks are special functions that allow functional components to use state and lifecycle methods without writing class components. They were introduced in React 16.8 to make component logic simpler, avoid the complexities of class components, and to promote code reuse. We have built-in hooks like useState, useEffect, and useRef, which help with different tasks. But did you know we can also create our own custom hooks? What are custom hooks? Custom hooks are JavaScript functions that use built-in hooks to create reusable logic. Instead of writing the same code in multiple components, we can put it inside a custom hook and use it whenever needed. This makes our components cleaner, avoids code duplication, and improves readability. Before we start, let me tell you there are a few important rules for creating custom hooks. The name must start with use, like useFetch. Custom hooks can only be used inside function components or other hooks. They must follow React's hook rules, meaning they should not be called inside loops, conditions, or nested functions. Why do we need custom hooks? Let me explain with an example. In this app, we have navigation links that take us to different pages. On the users page, we fetch and display a list of users. On the post page, we fetch and display a list of posts. Right now, both components have similar code. Three state variables to store data, loading status and errors, a useEffect hook to fetch data from an API, and we have error handling and loading indicators. Also, we are displaying data when it's ready. The only difference is the API URL. Since we are repeating the same logic in both components, it's not a good design. Instead, we can create a custom hook to handle this logic and reuse it in both components. Let me show you how we can do that. Let me create a new folder to keep all our custom hooks organized. Now I will create a new file and name it usefetch.js. I'll copy the fetching logic from the users component and move it here. Finally, I'll return the necessary state variables so that any component using this hook can access them. That's it. Our custom hook is ready. Now let's go back to the users component. We don't need the old fetching code anymore. Instead, we can simply use the useFetch hook like this. Let's do the same for the posts component. Now both components are much cleaner and easier to understand. Let's test it. It's working perfectly. But this time, our code is much cleaner since we are reusing the fetch logic with our custom useFetch hook. Let me show you another example using local storage. Now let me create another custom hook to store and retrieve data from local storage. This logic is simple and can be done without a hook. But I will use a custom hook for better reusability. Let me create a new file named uselocalstorage.js. And accept a key as a parameter. Then I'll create a function to save data in local storage using this key. Next, I'll create another function to retrieve data based on the key. Now in my home component, I will add an input box and a button. Let me use useRef to get the input value. And save it to local storage. Using my useLocalStorage hook. When the button is clicked, the data will be stored. And in the storage component, I already have a button that fetches data from local storage and sets it in the state. Now I will replace the existing code with my custom hook. Inside the getCountry function, I'll call getData from the hook and store the result in the state. Let's test it. It's working. Right now, our hook can only save and get data, but we can extend it to clear all data from local storage, remove specific data based on a key, and so on. Okay, before we close, I need to make you clear on one thing. At the beginning of the video, I mentioned that custom hook's name must start with use. But what happens if we don't follow this rule? Let's test it by renaming our hook. It still works. That's because React doesn't enforce this at runtime. However, it's not recommended because it breaks the naming convention, making it harder to identify as a hook. It may cause issues with linting and debugging. Following the correct naming convention makes our code more readable and maintainable. That's all for today. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment with your thoughts or any topics you'd like me to cover next. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Bye.